สวัสดีค่ะ This is Thailand Today and I am Kusuma Yothasmut. Today we are at the event celebrating 40th anniversary of our relationship with Sarawak Republic. Although Sarawak Republic and Thailand established our relationship in 1993 or about 26 years ago. Slovak was part of the former Czechoslovakia when we formally formed diplomatic relations with it in 1974. So we today, or we have the honor to participate and to anticipate also the joint celebration of the two countries. Before we meet a Slovak Republic representative today, so let us know a little bit or more or less about Slovak Republic in general.
Your Excellency, thank you very much for sparing your precious time
to
make your country known to us all. So can you, how do you pronounce your name actually?
My name? Yes. Vladimir Halagas.
Oh, it's such a difficult name, but anyway, so thank you very much. So can you tell me, because the Thai will make them understand that before your country was together, Czechoslovakia, and then now, can you tell something about that in short, please?
Yeah, you know, matter of fact that practically nobody knows about Slovakia, because Slavic stays, they settled in the territory of Slovakia in 5th and 6th centuries. And since that time, we are practically a known nation, because we were known as Hungarians, Upper Hungarians, Northern Hungarians, or in Czechoslovakia we were known as Czechs because it was a convenient abbreviation for many people. So only 21 years ago we became Slovaks, an independent country. So that's why we are practically unknown, not only in Thailand but in many, many other countries. And in case people know anything about Slovakia, they often confuse us with Slovenia.
I see. Yeah. So if a Thai wanted to visit there, what are the places that you think that the Thai should go?
It depends. You know, we are a little bit different. We have a lot of similarities with Thailand, but we are a little bit different. We have four seasons of the year. As my predecessor, or one of my predecessors, informed me before coming to Thailand, that you have only two seasons of the year, hot and very hot. But we have four seasons, and any of this season has, you know, something unique. I know that you are not skiers, it's quite natural. But we have a lot of castles, a lot of historical monuments. We have a lot of spas. And they are unique spas, really, because they are helping to get back your health, as far as movement system is concerned, or digestive system is concerned. We have beautiful mountains. So really, any season of the year is good to visit Slovakia.
But how do we travel from Bangkok to?
The best way, there's a lot of flights, direct flights from Bangkok to Vienna. And Vienna, we used to say, it's the biggest suburb of Bratislava. It's only 40 kilometers from Bratislava. So it's 40 kilometers from Vienna airport to Slovak border. And I strongly recommend not stay in our capital, but go into the country and to see the country, to meet people.
Interesting. When we talk about all this, we definitely want to know about our diplomatic relations. So what do we could, where did we start contacting and all that?
We are contacting for many years, but we established our diplomatic relations 40 years ago. At that time it was Czechoslovakia and the Kingdom of Thailand. But in 1993, Czechoslovakia was divided into two sovereign states, Slovak Republic and the Czech Republic. And Thailand recognized Slovakia as independent country in January 1st, 1993. But we do not see this celebration of 40th anniversary as a kind of preparation for our 40th anniversary of Slovak Thai relations, because we see relations with between countries, not between countries as such, but more the relations between people.
People and the trade. Do we have any trade or investment each other?
Yeah, we have trade, but I would prefer not to speak about concrete numbers because they are fine behind our expectations. But there's a lot of possibilities in many fields because you are big car producers, we are big car producers, but we are not producing Chinese cars, we are producing Volkswagen, Citroën, Peugeot, Kia, and we are producing, we are among biggest, world biggest car producers. Per capita we are producing about 170 cars. It means about 950,000 cars per year. So it's a big number, but it's good possibility for cooperation, but we have good exchange in the field of pharmaceutical production, chemistry. From Thailand, we are importing, of course, textile, silk, fruits, vegetables, traditional goods coming from Thailand.
Yeah. We are in next year, maybe, with we are joining into one country of ASEAN, you know, the 10 countries in ASEAN. But how do you how ready you are to cooperate or, you know, with the ASEAN community?
You know, at the beginning I mentioned that Slovakia is a rather young country, and that's why we were concentrating mostly on our relations with European countries, with our neighbors. But now is the time to cross the border and to go further. So now we are approaching our partners in Asian countries, for example, including Thailand. And we see it as a very important because, you know, the life is going very quickly now, and it's necessary to use any opportunity for mutually beneficial and fruitful cooperation. And we see our role as an EU country, as independent Slovakia, to develop our bilateral relation with ASEAN countries, including Thailand. So that's my role here, that's the role of Slovakia in this region.
What is your population?
It's 5.5 million people. Not big.
Not big, but big country, but, you know, this thing. By the way, you are here in Thailand for how many?
I came in September 2011.
Okay, so you might have heard about our king project and all that. So what do you think about all that?
You know, it's very good for people to have such a great man who is leading them, who is giving example how to solve their problems, how to make the standard of life much higher. So you have to be very grateful to His Majesty.
Imagine. But before we, this is my last question, but I want you to tell me today, what do we expect to promote the 40th you know, diplomatic relation with this country? So what do you want to have here tonight? Is there any particular?
You know, Slovakia, in spite of the fact that it's a young country, we pass through a lot of turbulent periods. We pass through 4, if I'm not mistaken, or 5 even, different systems. Last time it was 20 years ago. So we have first-hand experience in dealing with political and economical reforms. And I am of the opinion that that's good basis for cooperation between our two countries. Because are ready to help each other in any time. So that's, we are here, and that's what I am going to propose today.
But I give you just a minute to and convey to the Thai people, to convince them to visit Slovakia?
You know, it's very easy to listen to any representative of foreign country, but it's very difficult to describe our countries to you, and I am sure that even internet will fail. The best way how to get deeper knowledge about any country is to go there and to visit the country. So I kindly invite you, come to Slovakia.
Please do. Thank you very much, Excellency.
You're welcome. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Trading with Slovakia. Thailand mostly imports machinery and parts, car parts and equipment and chemicals. Thailand exports computers, computer parts, transformers and parts, including electronic. In 2013, Thailand had 118.3 million trade surplus with Slovakia. Slovakia GDP per capita purchasing power parity was 118,000 in 2010, which was 24% of the EU average. Its economy also grew by 4.0, which was the highest growth among new UE member countries.
Slovakia. Little big country.
The Slovak Republic, Slovakia, is one of the youngest European countries. It was created in 1993 in a peaceful dissolution of Czechoslovakia, and from 2004 has been a member state of the European Union and NATO. Near the Church of St. John. Slovakia, with an area of 49,035 square kilometres, has 5.5 million inhabitants, and the capital city is Bratislava. Neighbouring countries of Slovakia are the Czech Republic, Poland, Ukraine, Hungary, and Austria. Slovakia is known for its natural beauties, cultural and historical monuments. Thanks to this wealth, several places in Slovakia were given international recognition and were enlisted into the UNESCO list of World Heritage. The objective of the International Programme of World Heritage, governed by UNESCO, is to make a list of and protect cultural and natural places of remarkable importance as the common human heritage. The historical centre of Badia Jor, the historical centre of Banská Štiavnica and its technical monuments. Our extraordinary caves of Slovenský Kras. The inhabited mountain village of Vokolinec. The largest castle of Spišský Hrad and its surroundings. The newly added historical town of Levoča and masterpiece of Master Paul. Primeval beech forests of the Carpathians and wooden churches in northeastern Slovakia are on this list. The reservation of folk architecture in Vokolinec was added to the UNESCO list of World Heritage in 1993. The architecture of Vokolinec is typical for mountainous settlements. Log houses of mountainous type with the pastel-coloured plaster and roofs covered with wood shingle. In the village, there are more than 40 wooden houses that date back to the 16th and 19th centuries. That is why they represent the most preserved and compact urban complex of original folk buildings in Central Europe. Banská Štěnice, a historical mining town situated in the middle of the forests of Štěnice v Rocky Mountains, and technical monuments of its surroundings in central Slovakia, were enlisted into the UNESCO list of World Heritage in 1993. The historical core of Banská Štěnice was declared a town conservation reservation in 1950. Starý Zámok, old castle lying at the terrace of Trojice Náměstí, Trinity Square, dominates the town centre. At the opposite hill, the Nový Zámok, new castle, is situated, and since 1571, it offers a wonderful view over the town. The main monuments of Banská Štěnice are concentrated in the inner zone between the Trojice Náměstí, Trinity Square, and Radnice Náměstí, Town Hall Square. In the lower part of Radnice Náměstí Square, there is the bell tower, the town hall, and the Church of St. Katarina of the 15th century. The open-air mining museum in nature was made accessible in 1974 in the original mining works of a shaft called André from the 16th century and of a tunnel called Bartolomé from the 16th and 17th centuries. It is situated 2 kilometers away from Banská Štěnice, near the route to Štítanické Bagneur, under Lake Klingau. Another Slovak town inscribed into the UNESCO list of World Cultural Heritage is Bagea Jor, one of the oldest towns in Slovakia. The most precious part of the town is Radnice Náměstí, the town hall square, with wonderful Gothic burgher's houses. The Basilica Minor of St. Egidius, the Gothic three-aisled basilica built at the place of the former monastery complex of Cistercians, and with a set of 11 late Gothic field altars, and with the former town hall, the first Renaissance building in a territory of Slovakia. The square of Bagea Jor was once a market square in the Middle Ages. Fairs took place there. Spišské Hrad Castle was enlisted into the UNESCO list of World Cultural Heritage in 1993 and lies in the northern part of Slovakia, over the town of Spišský pod Hradom. Spišský Hrad Castle is one of the largest castles in Europe. There is an arms exposition inside. It is formed with the Renaissance and Gothic buildings that several monarchs and owners of the castle built in stages. It has a very rich history, and in the past, the castle served as a military fortress and as a residence of Župan, the district administrator in Slovakia. The castle was built in the 12th century and completely rebuilt in the 15th. The reconstructed parts of Spišský Hrad Castle serve now as a museum with historical expositions documenting the history of castle settlement, its building, arms and torture chamber. The town of Spišský Kapitula is a part of Spišský pod Hradom from 1948. It is a little church town situated on the hill and developed in the 12th century around the church. In 2008, 8 historical wooden churches situated in the northeastern part of Slovakia were enlisted into the UNESCO list of World Cultural Heritage. The oldest churches date back to the 16th century, and in some of them the church service is still taking place nowadays. On the UNESCO list, the wooden churches of the following towns and villages were enlisted: Greek Catholic churches in Ruska Bystra, Ladomirova, Bodrušal, Roman Catholic churches in Trudošín, Hervator near Bagea Jor, Evangelical churches in Kešmarok, Hronsek, Leštiny. The town hall of Levoča is situated in the middle of the main square of Master Paul. Originally, along with its administration and representation purposes, its basement also served as a market house. From the older Gothic building, only the fragments of the walls in the southern part of the town hall were preserved. The Gothic building was destroyed in 1550 in a big fire, during which the town archive was also burnt. The construction of the present Renaissance Town Hall was finished in 1615. The Town Hall went through reconstruction from 1893 to 1895, when the roofing of the building was changed to high attic with gables, in the spirit of German Renaissance. Thousands of pilgrims annually visit Marianska Hora in Levoča to draw a spiritual force here. It was the only destination of the Holy Father visiting Slovakia in 1995. The caves in the Slovenský Kras area were enlisted in the UNESCO list of World Natural Heritage together with the caves in Hungary. It happened in 1995. Some of them are publicly accessible. The most valuable are Oktinska Aragonita Vyaskanau Cave and Dobšinska Ladovyaskanau Cave. The caves are situated in the districts of Rožňava and Spišský Nová Ves. The largest is the system of Demanovsky Vyaskanau Caves in the Low Tatras, around 34 kilometers long. The unique decoration at Oktinska Aragonita Vyaskanau is one of the only three publicly accessible aragonite caves in the world. Dobšinska Ladovyaskanau Cave is ranked among the caves with permanent ice filling. The ice volume is up to 110,132 cubic meters. Dormitska Cave is situated in the National Park of Slovenský Kras, at 339 meters above sea level, and creates one complex with the Hungarian Bauradla Cave. The fujara is the most typical Slovak musical instrument. The fujara musical instrument and its music were inscribed into the UNESCO list of the masterpieces of the Oral and Intangible Heritage of Humanity in November 2005. The list was founded in 2001. The fujara is an overtone fipple flute that can be up to 1.8 meters long and is usually made of elder tree with a distinctive meditation sound. It is known nowhere else in the world. Its place of birth is considered to be central Slovakia, the region of Poliana and North Gemer. It was a typical instrument of shepherds. Fujaras were decorated with ornaments and rarely with figural decorations. The longest instrument is the fujara trombita, up to 6 meters long. It was used for signaling and communication among the shepherds on the pastures, thanks to its robust and strong sound. It is made of white wood. Slovaks have many reasons to be a proud nation of a globalized world. Slovakia, with its cultural and natural values, is among the richest countries of Europe. Visit Slovakia and get to know the beauties of the UNESCO World Cultural and Natural Heritage of Slovakia.
Slovakia or Slovak Republic is fairly little known to Thais, but it is well known to others as it holds competitive reputations in the world of sports. You see more Slovak influence as the fastest growing in EU state in our ASEAN region in the years to come. We run out of time today, so you can follow Thailand Today at the same time on the NBT World. Thank you for watching and see you again next time.